Why don't you come on over, Valerie?
First date on Valentine's Day? That's some shit that's doomed from the get-go. Way too many expectations on that one.
Yeah, probably not a good idea. I don't know, they just seem so nice, and it just seemed nice. I don't know. I just didn't want to be alone on Valentine's Day again.
Well, hey, it's not over, and I mean, hell, no reason to waste your perfectly good reservation. I mean, this is a pretty nice place. I'll leave with you.
We barely know each other. That would be a little weird.
Weirder stuff has happened. I mean, come on, it's just lunch. We can get to know each other. It'll be fun. Name's Helen. What's yours?
Callie.
That's a good name. Wonderful name. Good on your parents. It suits you. Your table? Oh, madame. Oh, you're most welcome. So, where do I start? Tell me about yourself.
Did you just throw that fork?
Oh, yeah, I did.
Why?
Oh, yeah, so when I was a kid, I was playing with a fork at dinner, and I tore my arm up real bad. See that? Yeah, so my mama made me promise to not play with forks anymore. So I said, Mama, what if I can't help myself? And so she said, if one cannot resist the object of temptation, they must do their best to remove said object. So every time I see a fork, I just get rid of it. Easy peasy.
To eat something like steak? I mean, you kind of need a fork for that. Also, why can't you just learn how to use a fork instead of trying to avoid it? I mean, that sounds easier, right?
Easier?
Than having to get rid of your forks all the time. I mean, you're avoiding it because what, you're scared? Also, kind of rude to the people working at the restaurant that you can't just wait for them to take it away.
Huh. Yeah, I guess you're right. Hey, hello. Yeah, you. What's your name?
Jack, ma'am. What can I do for you?
Please, my name's Helen. I'm not a ma'am, but could you take that fork away? I just really don't want it anymore.
Sure. That's no problem. Is there anything else I can get for you?
Could I have some water?
Sure, I'll bring that right out.
Nice kid. So, tell me about yourself.
What do you want to know?
Anything. Literally anything.
Okay, let me think. Well, you were talking about your mom earlier. My mom was a sweet lady, kind of stout and short with me, but she was sweet. She used to make my lunch every day throughout high school. She never used to let me leave the house without a brown paper bag in my hand. I used to complain about it a lot, but she used to say, Callie, you're gonna grow up soon, and I won't be able to make anything for you, and I'll only see you on holiday, so let me just do this one thing for you. And I may have grumbled about it, but I never tried to stop her or even wanted her to. But I wouldn't give her one of those lunches right now.
You should go get one.
What do you mean?
Go back home, visit, ask her to make you something for old time's sake. I'm sure she'd love it.
Yeah, it's been a while. Last Christmas, my dad and I sort of had a bit of a falling out. Basically told me he never wanted to see me again. So, haven't really had the chance to come back.
Oh. You two fight often?
Actually, no. Only about 3 or 4 times a week growing up.
Oh, and this time?
It was different. I kind of told him something that he couldn't forgive me for.
Tell me. If you want to. I'm sorry, that was forward. I'm interested. Just a lot to talk about. Yeah, no worries. So, Callie, what do you do? Like, hobbies and stuff.
I watch TV. I read. I write a little bit.
Writing? What do you write?
This and that. A few short stories. Poetry.
Poetry? I love poetry. Oh my god, you have to read me something.
Oh no, it's a little bit cheesy.
Cheesy? Poetry is supposed to be cheesy. I mean, the cheesier the better. Please. That one. Read that one.
Why?
Your face. You're worried about it, but you like it.
Hey, come on.
Oh, no.
Come on, grab it.
You do it.
Okay. Trip away from you.
Our hearts strung out over 1,000 miles of asphalt and rest stop bathrooms, screaming along to old love songs far too overplayed. I'll be there soon. Soaring over cement somewhere in a cornfield in Kansas. So essentially, anywhere in Kansas. I look out at a sun sinking towards slumber. I find your beauty in the colors of the sky, the green of your eyes and the pasture that spread like an ocean around me. My car, a life raft delivering me to your shores. All American beauty. A Midwest-grown lover's kiss sits on the edge of your lips, like the quintessential American romance. What is better than this, or more pure, or more predictable? I drive, fly, ride, walk, crawl, or drag myself across the earth to taste your smile. God, just getting to you is sweet as wine. Knowing you're waiting for me, like the night sky waits for the moon, or a woman somewhere in her home waits for a call of good news she will never get. The anticipation makes release oh so sweeter. As I drive through the Colorado night, the wind howls around me, and the moon hangs like a spotlight, driving me towards you. I'm still over 500 miles out, but I can smell your scent over the night air and taste your lips through my cheap gas station coffee and cigarette smoke. On the dashboard next to me, my phone lights up with a message from you. Hurry home. I'm missing you still. I reach my arms out and they seem to stretch over an infinity, reaching for your hands. I am searching for that kiss.
And I know I'll find it soon. In love with the idea of being in love. I've never been so lucky.
Me either. But wow, that was beautiful. You have a romantic's heart.
Thank you. You know, I've never read that out loud before, so you're the first.
I'm honored, honestly.
So,
I am so sorry. Things have just been so hectic. I didn't mean to take so long. I'm really sorry.
Okay, I'm gonna need you to set the waters down. Alright. Very hard. And I'm not going to fault you because I had to wait a couple minutes for some water. I'm like a good kid.
Thank you. Some people get pretty angry. If we take too long, and I'm not a very confrontational person, so it's just really scary sometimes.
Fuck them. Fuck them. If they're not worth your time, fuck them. Some people are assholes, and you can't waste your time and energy on them. At the end of the day, they're gonna shut up and eat the food anyway, even if it's a couple minutes late.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Anytime.
That was really nice of you to say to him.
I mean, I meant it and he needed it, so why not?
I don't know. I just feel like people will get uncomfortable if I say something that I mean or think.
You should just say it. Say what you mean. I mean, if the person you're talking to can't accept it, they're not someone worth having in your life, right?
I guess you're right.
Oh, okay, I'm really sorry. I have gotta take this. Hold that thought. Okay, hello. This is she. I'm sorry, what? Is she okay? Okay, yeah, I will be right there. Thank you. I'm really sorry.
Is everything okay?
I've gotta go. No, I don't know. I'm sorry.
Romantic's heart.
Callie? Oh, wow. Hello. You're certainly coming out of your shell.
Yeah, well, someone really cool once told me that if someone doesn't like you, then you don't have to waste your energy on them. Like, shut up and eat the food anyway.
Sounds like she doesn't know what she's talking about.
Maybe, but I've been waiting a while to find out.
Wow, it's great to see you too. How have you been?
No, how have you been? You just ran out and I was worried.
Yeah, things are okay. They almost weren't. My mom was in an accident and they called while she was in surgery and things didn't look good, but she's a fighter and she pulled through.
It's
okay. Wow, I didn't expect you to care this much. Why?
Helen, I know we barely know each other, but you kind of invited yourself to my failure of a first date, and listening to you made me so happy, and you're just so sweet and funny, and you don't even mean to be. I like you. I think we should go out again and get to know each other, talk more, and pop a kiss.
What?
Kiss. Thank you. Well, for you. Flowers are beautiful, right?
Yeah, they are. You want to get some lunch?
I really do.
Hold me close and hold me fast. This magic spell you cast.
Thank you.